You may have seen this mouse pop up on your Instagram and TikTok feed and thought to yourself, what are all those crazy features all about? Well, in this video, we're diving deep into the top 5 most viral features of the Swiftpoint Z2. Stick around because not only will I show you how these features work, but I'll show you how they can level up your gaming and productivity. I'm Sean from Swiftpoint and we're all about innovation, ergonomics, and unlocking your full potential whether for work or play. So let's dive into it. So feature number one is a swappable feet. The Swiftpoint Z2 comes with 2 sets of feet in the box. We've got the tilt feet and we've got the lockout feet. So the tilt feet are for those of you who want another level of customization within your gaming setup, and for those of you who want to unlock the gyroscope features of the Swiftpoint Z2. The Swiftpoint Z2's feet come with 3 levels of tilt angle. The wider you go, the less tilt you have. The further in to the base of the mouse you go, the more tilt you have. These little magnets make it super easy to attach your tilt feet to the base of the Z2. Now, as mentioned earlier in the video, if you want less of a tilt angle, then you have it set up to the widest groove here on the base of the mouse for both of the feet, the left and the right. And if you want a bigger tilt angle, then simply just lift it up from the front of the foot and move it to the furthest slot in to the base of the mouse. And when you place your Z2 down on your desk, you will now have the widest tilt angle. So now that you have your tilt angle set within the X1 control panel, you can now customize your tilt angles to perform unique actions. The most loved unique action would be tilt to lean within games like Rainbow Six and Escape from Tarkov. This means that you don't have to be hitting Q and E on the keyboard for those of you who particularly don't enjoy doing those actions. Or for you productivity users, this is an awesome feature set to be able to do quick actions like switching between browser tabs or your most used functions within your productivity software. So moving on to feature number 2, which is deep click technology. This isn't your average mouse click. The harder you press on the 5x pressure sensitive buttons, the more actions you can activate. One particular use case of deep click is for sniping within FPS games. Now you can press your right click button once to bring up your sights. You can press harder again to zoom in. You can press harder again to hold your breath, and then harder once more to fire your weapon. Or a productivity use case could be you could press once to copy and press harder again to paste. The great thing with deep click is you can jump in to the X1 control panel and customize those deep click features even further by choosing your level of deep click and the actuation point. And also, bonus feature, you can pair it with the Z2's vibration motor for haptic feedback to give you a physical alert in your hand when you have hit those deep click levels. Feature number 3, swappable button caps. Now, the Z2 out of the box comes pre-installed with the long fingertip caps, which you can see right here. Now, we understand that not everybody enjoys using the long fingertip caps that are pre-installed on the Z2 because everybody's hands are different sizes. So inside of the Z2's box, you'll have a small accessories pack, and inside that accessories pack, you will find what we call the short fingertip caps. So those short fingertip caps will look like this. I appreciate it might be hard for you guys to see that on the video, but these allow you to simply take out the long fingertip caps by getting your finger underneath the front of the cap here and just pulling them out simply like so, and then switching them over for the short fingertip caps that you place into the slot where the long fingertip caps were. And now, by swapping out the long fingertip caps to the short fingertip caps, you have significantly changed the shape, look, and feel of the Swiftpoint Z2. So the next set of button caps that you can change are the trigger caps. Now, pre-installed out of the box, the Z2 comes with what we call the high profile trigger caps. These just sit a little bit above the shell of the mouse, making it easy for you to use the underside of your finger to click down on the trigger caps. If you don't like the high profile trigger caps, once again, inside of the Z2's box in the accessories pack, you will have the low profile trigger cap. Once again, I appreciate it's probably hard for you guys to see on the video, but you can simply just get your finger underneath the high profile trigger caps, pull them off, and simply insert the low profile trigger cap to be changed over from the high profile to the low profile, allowing your fingers to sit more flush on the Z2. Feature number four is 13 programmable buttons. We've designed the Swiftpoint Z2 so you can easily reach all of the buttons without having to change your grip. You may have noticed that the Swiftpoint Z2 only actually has 11 physical buttons. That is because the two trigger buttons on the top of the mouse here can be pushed and pulled. Unlike other mice on the market, we've designed our thumb buttons to be one above the other instead of side by side. The reason for this is because it allows you to easily be able to roll your thumb up and down the thumb buttons to activate those easily. One particular feature that we would love to draw your attention to that is super powerful is input nesting. You may be familiar with the likes of Hypershift and G-Shift. Now, Hypershift and G-Shift make you press one button to switch into another profile or another layer of actions, and then press that button again to switch back to your original profile. With the Swiftpoint Z2, you can program all of your actions, your strings of actions, and your most used commands within games to any of the buttons and have those be activated at any moment. So what this means is within the X1 control panel, you assign a string of actions to any of the Z2's 13 buttons. A brief and simple example of input nesting could be beginning the string of actions with the right click button and assigning a command to the lower or upper thumb button. And once you have actioned the commands on the lower and upper thumb button and you release your right click button, you will instantly be put back to your original profile. And that brings us to feature number five, and that is the OLED screen on the Z2. Now, I completely understand the OLED screen is quite a novel feature for many of you, but used in the right way, it can be an incredibly powerful feature. With the OLED screen, you can use it to have a quick glance at your DPI, your current profile, and also your force percentages. When taking a quick glance at your DPI or your current profile, we recommend doing this as you are dropping into a game or you are either in the lobby. We don't recommend doing it so much within the heat of the game because, of course, you want to be focused on what you are doing. The OLED screen is also super beneficial for those of you who are going to be setting up your deep click levels because you can look at your OLED screen and make sure that your action is actually activating at the right deep click level that you have set in the X1 control panel. And for those of you who aren't going to be making the most of the OLED display on the Z2, you can simply disable it within the X1 control panel, or you can have a custom message that you can set within the X1 control panel, or you can have the original Z Cube logo showing. So there we have it, the top five features of the Swiftpoint Z2 as voted for by you guys on social media. And as mentioned before, these features are there to help level up your productivity and your gaming experience whilst using the Swiftpoint Z2. Let us know down in the comments which feature of the top five is your favorite. And as always, if you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button, hit the like button, and we will see you guys on the next video.